Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here for Accounting and Mathematics, Pearson, Edexcel, Cambridge, IGCSE, O-Levels, A-Levels, as well as we are offering other boards like AQA as well. So we are today going to discuss this an overview video about the IGCSE Mathematics paper pattern and the syllabus changes, okay? Because from 2025 onwards, the exam pattern is changing, plus some topics are being removed and some topics are basically going to be part of the syllabus now. So this video is particularly for 0580 IGCSE Mathematics, and it will be discussing about the extended one only, okay? So if students understand, the extended are basically paper 2 and paper 4, okay? So we'll make a separate video on core later on, but this is about paper 2 and paper 4 for IGCSE Mathematics 0580. This syllabus will be applied from 2025 till 2027. So it will be from May-June 2025 session till 2027 paper. The first important thing is that we are going to talk about is the paper pattern. Students need to understand that now a lot of focus will be paper 2 will be now a non-calculator paper, okay? So main difference that we are facing will be it's a non-calculator paper now. Paper 2 will be a non-calculator, but in paper 4 the calculator will be allowed, okay? So basically they are just like to trying to get, or they are trying to become like the GCSE O-Level Maths 4024. So almost the syllabus will be 95% same for both of them, okay? 90-95% range is the same. Okay, O-Level Maths 4024 be same hoga, and IGCS Maths 0580 be same hoga. One of the major thing, pehla point kya hai, ke paper 2 is now a non-calculator and paper 4 is a calculator paper. Then we talk about both of them have the same weightage now. So it is 50% weightage, this one, and 50% weightage is this one as well. So both of them will have the same weightage, 50%, 50% weightage both of them have, sir. Next, we talk about that this paper is of 2 hours now as well, paper 2 extended, and paper 4 also extended will be of 2 hours, okay, students? So both of the papers will be 2 hours each, okay? Both of the papers will be 2 hours each, and each paper will be of 100 marks, okay, students? So each paper will be of 100 marks, paper 2 as well, and paper 4 as well will be of 100 marks, students. So that is what the case is here. This is paper pattern that we are discussing in summarizing form. Okay, so it will be paper 2 is non-calculator, paper 4 will be calculator, sir. Both of them have equal weightage, equal number of marks, and it will be 100 marks each. Both of the papers will be to 2 hours each. The next important thing is basically now they are going to give you the formula sheet as well, okay, students? So now students will have a formula sheet as well in both papers. I'll repeat, we are talking about extended papers only for 0580. So make sure wherever you are from anywhere part of the world, follow this video to understand the concept and what will be the paper pattern, what will be the syllabus changes. So the formula sheet will be given to you, and the formula sheet is basically available on the Cambridge website as well. I'll be teaching that as discussion as well. But just to give a quick overview, students need to understand that they will be given now sign rule. Basically, the formulas will be most related to mensuration topic, like area of circle, circumference of the circle, pyramid, cylinder, sphere, cone. These all items, okay, like cylinder, circumference, area of the triangle, area of non-right angle triangle, sine rule, cosine rule. So basically the 3D, 2D shapes, and these will be the areas given, okay? So let's write down like 2D, 3D shapes, okay? Most probably 3D shapes, okay? Like cone, pyramid, spheres, and those things, okay? So we can say that 3D shapes, other than that, like cone, sphere, pyramid, cylinder. So these will be, the formula sheet will be given. So this was about paper pattern. Now let's talk about syllabus changes as well, okay? And together with that, I'll give you a brief overview about. So basically, how I teach the syllabus, if students are looking to join for the next session, we have I divide the syllabus into 9 parts, okay, 9 sections, okay. It is like numbers. We start off with numbers, okay. So everyone knows what we have, a lot of chapters. We'll have a detailed discussion. It's just an overview of what you can expect in all these chapters, okay. So in numbers, we can have fractions, decimals, simple interest, compound interest, profit, loss, percentages, all of these chapters. Then we do algebra and graphs, in which it's about the quadratic formulas, functions, and different types of graphs, okay. Sequences comes in there, a lot of other topics like direct, inverse, proportion, and etc. etc. As I said, we'll have a detailed discussion. Then we move on, we have coordinate geometry, midpoints, perpendicular bisectors, equation of perpendicular lines, parallel lines, angles. Geometry is all about angles, circle theorems, and parallel lines formulas. Mensuration is all about area, perimeter, volume, surface area. Trigonometry is about the sine rule, cosine rule, 3D shapes, area with the base, and those things. We have transformations and vectors as the common topic from a lot of time. Nothing changed in that. And then we have probability and statistics, in which we have to discuss about cumulative frequency, histograms, bar graphs, pie charts, and those things. So this is how I do the syllabus in 9 parts division, with all the topical worksheets, early past papers from 2016 to the recent onwards, 2018-2020, we do early and topical past papers, just an overview. And now, the most important part of the video, what is the syllabus change? So if you talk about the syllabus change, students, we need to understand, sir, that these are the content that are being added. So from the additional mathematics, like we have talked about AdMaths as well. So this is what they have done. Basically, they have added on the search topic, okay? I'll be giving an example quick. What does search means? It's in the form of square root, okay? So you need to understand that there will be search now. So you can say example. That is basically like what will be the square root of 20. So you have to work out for this. There's already common in basically Pearson ed Excel. We'll talk about that later on. So this is like 10 square root 5 will become 2 square root 5, how it become this thing. So we'll talk about these things, okay, certs. Then they have added, students, domain and range for functions, okay. So the domain and range for functions are added from the, you can say that they have taken just the overview from the AS level mathematics functions, but it's very basic level functions, okay. So we can say कि आपको domain and range भी test होगी from now onwards, जो कि already ed Excel में test हो रही है, Pearson ed Excel 4 MA1. So it will be very simple case that what are the x values for domain, y values for range. Then you can say that they will be also testing on exponential graphs. Okay, students, exponential graphs are now becoming part of the syllabus, where you can have negative powers as well, like negative half, negative decimal powers as well, positive half power. So we can say that now you'll be tested on exponential graphs as well, where we have to communicate here that they can test you on the values of minus half and half. This is a special focus on the exam. So basically, I'm giving a summary of what is there for the syllabus in teachers to the students and parents, so they understand that what they should expect now, what is the main focus, what will be more tested. And now again, from the AdMaths, they have brought this here, or from the AS level maths, okay, trigonometric values will be there, okay. So you need to know about some trigonometric values. For example, students, because they have added, you must know what is sine 30, 60, 0 degrees, 90 degrees. This values you must know now. That is what they are looking forward, that students must know the values of 0, 30, 60, 45 degrees for sine, cos, and 10, okay? Because trigonometric solving was already there in IGCSE Math 0580. So now, which means that there's a hint as well that trigonometry ko question ab wo paper 2 mein poochenge. Trigonometry question might come in paper as well. So you must know the values for 0, 30, 45, 60, 90 for sine, cos, and 10. So these are the most important things that are added. And to talk about what have been removed, students. So the syllabus part that have been removed, sir, is box and whisker. Although it was very easy, according to me, and my students think that it is easy topic, but this they have removed now, box and whisker. So you can say that there are some changes from the perspective of statistics. So statistics mein se aapka probability mein se box and whisker remove ho gaya, students. Then they have removed, you will not be tested on proper subsets. Subsets will not come with the sets and Venn diagram chapter in the numbers section. Numbers section mein sets and Venn diagrams bhi I teach, so proper subsets will not be tested. Then you have linear programming as well. So linear programming is also removed as well. Linear programming, and you must know about the congruency criteria is removed, but you still have the basic knowledge of congruency that you know. Okay, congruency is all about three sides are same, three inside the angles will be same. Okay, angles, sides are same. So that is what we need to know about congruency. But the congruency proving, which basically means that they are not going to test you on congruency criteria. Congruency proving, okay, congruency proving test nahi hogi students. Apart from this, if we summarize the whole IGCSE Math 0580, if you start quickly, if you start from scratch, you can easily cover the syllabus in 7 to 8 months properly with complete past paper practice, ALE practice. So 7 to 8 months, or at some cases 10 months as well. It usually depends on the students. But what we need to focus, that they will be testing, they have put more stress. Some topics will be tested more from now onwards, and they are testing on sine, cosine rule more now. They will be testing on bar charts, pie charts, so statistics somewhat, and also about the net diagrams of cubes, cuboids. So we'll be discussing a lot of those questions as well in our this session for the next session. So bar graphs, these will be focused more, okay, stress will be more on those. So I think I have covered everything from the every perspective for the extended. Hope students get it. And if any questions can be asked using my WhatsApp number, bottom or IMO as well, I'm available. Or you can connect me on Messenger as well. My number is available on my YouTube as well. Make sure to follow and subscribe to get more idea about the content coming soon on my channel. Thank you. Have a great day from wherever you are watching this video, any part of the world. Thank you.